Okay, so now we're going to go over some apparatus we use for the conductivity and electrochemistry experiment. If you look here, I have two different types of conductivity meters. This is a home-built one, and this is a commercial one. Now, the home-built one is incredibly simple, and if it breaks, you can fix everything with just a screwdriver. Main thing you got to do is, it has no off switch, so you just plug in the battery when you're ready to go. And as you can see, if the battery is plugged in and the leads, battery's got to be clipped in well, and the leads come into conducting solution, the light goes on. So if there's a conductive material between the two screws here, between the leads, the light will go on. So let's check if this solution over here is conductive. I just immerse the two leads, and you can see the light go on. Take it out, it goes off, so it's all good. This is incredibly easy to use. Just please do us a favor and remember to unplug the battery when you are finished. Otherwise, the leads will drain the battery and lose. We'll pay for it. Now, this is a commercial conductivity meter designed for use in an aquarium. It has one control, the on-off button. Don't worry about what the hole does. You don't need it. Now, it reads three digits, and it reports with units of ppm, parts per million. Your lab will explain about that. Parts per million is not actually a measurement of conductivity. It's a measurement of concentration. The instrument is designed to measure aquarium tanks, and it assumes things about what's in the tank that allows it to figure out how much is there. We don't need to worry about that much. We're just going to see what kind of measurement we can take of a conducting solution here. So I immerse the tips, and you can see it starts reading 754. It's flipping around a bit. We'll let it come to equilibrium. Let's say 644, and you'll notice there's a little times 10 blinking down there. What that's telling you is that you're over 1,000 parts per million according to this measurement. What it's reporting to you is that actually you have 6,440 parts per million. So that's what you would write down in your manual. Now, this is a mistake, I should add. This instrument isn't designed to read as high a salt concentration as we have in that solution. You'll find that as you go through the procedure for the experiment that it won't work. But the advantage of this instrument is that it can read lower ones very accurately, whereas the crude home-built one here is really only good for very concentrated solutions. When you're done with this, just press the off button. Again, save us on batteries. So the last thing I need to show off here is a tool you're going to use for the electrochemistry part of the experiment, where you build the cell. That's called a digital multimeter. And it looks kind of complicated because it does a lot of things, hence the multi. But you only need it to measure voltages. The voltage measurements that you want to take are over here. That's the V with the solid line, little dashed line over it. And you can adjust the scale anywhere in here. What these numbers tell you is the range over which it will do a measurement. So for instance here, it's saying that it'll go up to a 2-volt measurement. If I were to adjust it up to here, it'll go up to 20, up to 200, and so on. All right, and all I have to do is connect the leads that are shown here to the thing I want to measure. Now, there are very specific instructions about how to do that for the battery you build in the laboratory. I'll just do it here for the 9-volt battery we got. I'm setting it now so the scale goes to 2 volts, and as you would expect, if I plug it, if I attach the leads up here to the battery, it goes above that level. See, I was just showing a big one? Well, we tried to measure a 9-volt battery on a 2-volt scale. Of course, it doesn't work, so we adjust it. In this case, we'll go up to 20. We'll try it again. The end's up here. And now it's saying that our 9-volt battery reads as having about 9.6 volts, give or take. Could be the manufacturer overcharged it a bit, could be that our multimeter is off a bit in that range, but either way, that's about the value. Now, the one thing I'm gonna point out to you here is if you swap the leads, you put them on opposite sides now, the sign changes. It goes from being positive 9 point whatever to about negative 9 point whatever. The sign doesn't matter much for this lab, but just be aware that voltage does have a sign with it as well as having a magnitude. When you're done, just switch this back to the off position, and that's it. That's your electrochemistry apparatus. Enjoy.